over time, slower. I'm sober now, sort of see what is going on with me. Gotta shout out G. You did wrong, but it's done for the right. New friends, new flies, they swarm to the light. Money and a new girl, that's warm for the night. Do a whole light close, they warm for the night.
Guys and gals, it's your boy CHJ here, back with the beginning of the end of Distraint. Now, the good thing about this is that I have the second installment of this game, so pretty much instantly after I finish the first part, I'm going to start the second part. Hope you guys stay tuned for that. If not, I'll be sad to see you go. But if you do want to see that, feel free to leave a like and subscribe for more mediocre content. Anyways, without further ado, let's hop right into it. Oh, give me a sec. One good thing about this is that for the second part, there aren't going to be any ads. So that should be pretty nice. Oh, we've seen what the first boss is like. Like, we've seen what happened. So now we're going to see what the second boss is like. So I'm guessing one of these other safes opens. It's this one. Okay. Hey, it's my coffee mug. How did this get in here? You literally just checked it, like, the last time. Interesting. I bet it's not salty anymore. It's hard to say no to for the coffee, but maybe later. Interesting. Okay. How the heck did his coffee mug get in there? There's three safes and three bosses, so each safe has something in it that will give me a key as to how. I'm not drinking from the toilet. I just had to see what they would say. Water. Don't mind if I do. Okay. Found my coffee mug. I didn't know it was lost. Me neither. Bro, I'm just curious as to how the heck your coffee mug got in here, even though you've never actually been in the boss's house. Maybe talk to this guy with the coffee mug? Here, I'll let you borrow my mug. I already got a mug. Thank you, though. Okay, old dialogue. There's a question mark here. Unfortunately, that doesn't seem to do anything. Let's see what's in this room, I guess. No. I like how he just says no. No interesting dialogue here, I guess. No. One thing I can say, though, it must be really awkward that he's trying to leave his job while seeing that they're putting up a whole office for him and stuff. No. It's not ringing. Okay. Initially, I thought that what I had to do was find some way to lure the desk clerk out from where she is so I could interact with the desk. But now I'm not so sure. Okay, she's just gonna be cranky about it. Alright. I don't exactly know what to do right now. Maybe walk outside for a sec? No, I'm here to quit. I'm not going to chicken out. Wow, bro. I feel you. Maybe one more glass or mug. Gotta stay hydrated. I just realized that he's wearing like a funny little hat thing. No. 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 I bet it's not salty anymore. Maybe later, alright. There has to be some way to interact with something. I'm sure there's something I missed. Give me a sec while I figure this out. Uh-huh. So, through the power of saving my game before I do things, I found out that if you drink all the water and you go to Jenny, she gets up again. Perfect. Must drink more. I'm gonna burst. Whoops, I think I drank it all. Wait, so I don't get back my mug? Hey, but my mug, I wanna drink coffee. Hey, Jenny, I'm sorry to bother you again. What is it this time? There's no water in the water machine. I'm still thirsty. What? How? I just changed the bottle today. Okay, I'm going. Alright, Jenny, thanks. Now I get to talk to, I think it was McDade, probably. I'm gonna save the progress again. Okay, let me pause. All right, here we go again. I feel like it's McDade, so we're gonna check this room first. Yeah, it is. Oh, here we go again. Yeah? Mr. Jones is waiting on the line. Alright, connect him. This is McDade speaking. Hey man, this is J-Bomb. I haven't found a new apartment yet. Could you postpone the expropriation? Just a few weeks so I can find somewhere to stay. Anything else? Do you want me to look for you? Want me to hold your hand? And walk you across the fucking street? Stop calling here. I'll send someone there tomorrow to take care of things. But dude, farewell. Ha! Funny guy. I wasn't really fond of the guy either. But that was just unnecessarily cruel. Yeah, man, that was fucking brutal. Jeez. What do we do now? Hey, don't touch my phone, okay? Sorry. I'm guessing the phone is gonna have something to do with this. And I'm willing to bet that one of the safes opened. There she is back at the desk again. Alright. This is getting crazier. Oh, another safe opened. The one on the end. Let's see. It's a rag. Okay. It's not dusty and thus needs zero cleaning. I mean, yeah, this place is pretty neat. Wait, hold on. Okay. Hold up, let me just check one more time if there's anything else in there. MTE, all right. Well, here we go. So, I think I know what to do this time. I'm going to... I think I know what to do. I can literally plug the toilet. Let me try and urinate first. I'm tempted, but I don't like public toilets. You just drank like an entire thing of water, bro. Like, what the heck? His bladder is superhuman. All right, let me try and clog the toilet. Hopefully this won't clog the toilet. Whoops. Perfect. And now I have an excuse to get her away from the desk again. And to my final task. Jenny, the toilet's clogged. Could you go and take a look, please? What am I, a plumber? You know, we hired a janitor a little while back. I'll just call him. No, don't do it. I was going to talk to him anyway, so I might just as well tell him about the toilet. That's nice of you. Damn it. It's not that guy upstairs. Let me try and steal his phone real quick. Nope. So where am I supposed to look, though? Still no water. I thought Jenny would change the bottle. Yeah, that's kind of strange, mate. Where could this janitor be? Yo, mad respect to the person who made this game, though. It's genius. Like, the mental gymnastics I had to do to get this stuff to work. It's insane. First, I'm gonna try all the doors upstairs, and then I'm gonna go and try the exit. A thing I've noticed, though, it seems like sometimes when you walk a certain portion of the room, a jump scare or something triggers. If it was ringing, that would be sorcery, my guy. Like, if the line is disconnected and it's ringing, yeah, that's kind of spooky. Yep, definitely gotta go back outside. You don't say. What did I miss? Give me a second again. Okay, so after a little searching, guys, I found that I had forgotten the question mark in the corner of the upstairs. So let me go check that out now. Here we go. It should do something. Oh, yep. Oh, whoa, what is that thing? Ah, yes, very curious, very interesting. And now he's gonna go over and look at it. I just like how everybody's walking all funny and stuff. I turned the phone off. Okay, so he didn't see me. And now I'm guessing I go talk to her again. Nice. We've gotten Jenny to leave for the third time. Hopefully the last. From red to green plug. All set. And now we get to see what a dick Moore is. I love how she just walked off downstairs without remembering the janitor is upstairs. Here we go. What's up, Jenny? Mrs. Goodwin is waiting on the line. Can I connect her? Please do. Moore. Hi, Mr. Moore. This is Miss Goodwin. How do you do, Mrs. Goodwin? Not too well, to be honest. My pension isn't too much. All the meds are awfully expensive. Maybe you should have worked harder. Or eaten healthier. Your debt is only your own doing. That's not fair, Mr. Moore. You know my husband passed away, and all the bureaucracy and confusing laws. Well, I just don't think it's fair that I'd need to pay the inheritance tax. Well, you should have done the proper paperwork. There are laws, and you must honor them. I suppose, Mr. Moore, I suppose. Well, the reason I'm calling is that I'm asking you a little more time. I've been arranging my things and... No! The law does not compromise. There's nothing I can do. Surely they're... Goodbye. What's an old hag? Oh, shit. What the hell? Alright. Damn. This is pretty dark. The heck is that thing? Oh, I hate how the music's all creepy and slow now. Oh, shit. Go and show them, dear. Bro, must have been all those drugs you took that one time. The moment of truth, son. Here we go. Wait, what's this way? I need to know. Alright, so we're just gonna walk slowly towards the epic boss fight thing. Okay, That is freaky as fuck. Alright, nice. Alright, give me a sec. Alright, here we go. What's about to happen? I entered through the door. It was black as night and quiet as a grave. Only the pulse of my heart broke the silence. One more step, and the lights came alive with a shout. Surprise! The band started playing. Balloons floated to the ceiling. They were all there. My bosses, Jenny, and my colleagues. Wait, what colleagues? It took a moment for me to figure out what was going on. I had proved myself. The party was for me, for my partnership. I took a long breath and swallowed. I prepared myself to shout my resignation out loud. But then something happened. A purple silky cloth revealed its secret. A new sign with my name on it. Shit. Greed reared its ugly head, and my backbone snapped like a dry stick. Shit. But did you get your partnership? What happened next? Yeah, I got my partnership. Well, I suppressed my feelings, my guilt. I kept working for a few years. You sure you don't want a swig? No thanks, sir. I'm on duty. I hope you don't mind if I do. Not at all, sir. I lied to myself. It's all okay, I said to myself. I just kept blowing into the balloon, you know? It only stretches so far. My mind broke. I started slipping. Heck, maybe even I wanted to. Soon after that, I got fired. And the standard of living I was used to. I ran into debt big time. I lost everything. I feel pretty horrible for taking over your property now. Holy shit, it's the circle of life. It's the circle of fucking life. This shit got dark times a million. Listen, kid. The reason I told you my story. Please say no more, sir. You really remind me of when I was younger. He looks exactly like you, except without the stubble and the depression. I'll admit, your story really puzzles me. I will give my career a second thought for sure. This is probably the first good deed I've done in my entire life. Please think it through so you won't end up like me. I will. But, gosh, I hate doing this. You will have to move out by the end of this month. I know the drill, kid. Take care now. Damn, this shit got dark. I really hope you listen to my story. I think this is it. Yo. The bottle is empty. No more whiskey for me. It's not a gas oven. I can't kill myself with it. Wow, that got really fucking depressing. Jeez. I spent my last coin to buy the shotgun. You bought a shotgun with a coin. What kind of depression do you live in? I guess it's time to use it. My nigga, you about to blow your brains out, huh? No point start shooting around. Damn, bro. Depression. No, I will need the shotgun to end my days. Wow, bro, like. Don't you want to do it in public? Hold up. We are definitely saving the progress. I don't want to. Shoot the TV? No point start shooting around. Depressing to write the suicide notes. What do I have to say? What goes around comes around. Fuck it. That'll have to do. Wow. Aye, bro. So I guess we leave this on the table. I'll end my ambitious life in this humble chair. Wow, damn, bro, like, you got it all planned out and shit. So I definitely need to drop this note here. Keep it to yourself. Interesting. Toilet paper is the only thing that goes into the toilet. Along with your life, bro. All Alright, guys, I think I'm going to end it on this very depressing note. Anyways, I hope you like this playthrough. Let me know if you guys want more. Actually, nah, just kidding. I'm gonna make more anyway. But anyways, I'm gonna see you later.
On everything, I gave everything and got nothing back. Ain't looking for it, no pet on backs. That ain't how we got, where the fuck we at? Mama called, where the fuck you at? On the road and I ain't coming back. Into my 100 stacks, make 100 racks. And that 100 racks bring a bundle back.